you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Let's lift up our hands to the Almighty God as we worship Him from the depth of our heart. Let's appreciate the giver of life, the one who woke us up this morning. Let's glorify His holy name. Let's praise Him from the depth of our heart. Let's lift Him high, 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 high. Say, Mighty God, say, Waymaker. Thank you, Father. We bless you. We glorify your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Be thou exalted in Jesus' mighty name. Praising the Lord always. Praising the Lord always. Praising the Lord with all my heart. Praising the Lord with all my heart always. Praising the Lord always, praising the Lord, always, praising the Lord, with all my heart, praising the Lord, with all my heart, always. Jehovah, you are the Most High, Jehovah, you are the Most High God. Jehovah, you are the Most High. Jehovah, you are the Most High God. Jehovah, you are the Most High. Jehovah, you are the Most High God. Jehovah, you are the Most High. Jesus, you are the Most High God. Only you can do what no man can do, Jehovah. Only you can do what no man can do, Jehovah. Only you can do what no man can do, Jehovah. Only you can do what no man can do, Jehovah. Only you can do what no man can do, Jehovah. Let's bless Him. Let's glorify Him. Lift up His name. Appreciate Him. The Waymaker, King of Kings, Lord of Lords. We bless you in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. I want to believe God that this prayer meeting will turn your life around for good in the name of Jesus Christ. As we pray this prayer, the story of your life will change in the mighty name of Jesus. As we pray this prayer, the Lord God Almighty will empower you internally and will also empower you spiritually in the mighty name of Jesus. As we pray this prayer, the evil power that has been eating up your spiritual life, they shall die in the mighty name of Jesus. As you pray this prayer, every evil bird that is flying for your sake, they will crash land in the mighty name of Jesus. As you pray this prayer, any form of internal enemy in your camp, they shall be displaced in the mighty name of Jesus. And as you pray this prayer, the chain of wickedness against you shall break off in the mighty name of Jesus. Now raise up your voice and say, every witchcraft conspiracy against my life and destiny, scatter in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft conspiracy against my life and destiny, scatter in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft conspiracy against my life and destiny, scatter in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft conspiracy against my life and destiny, scatter in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft conspiracy against my life and destiny, scatter in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft conspiracy against my life and destiny, scatter in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Now say this one loud and clear. Cycle of generational failure in my life, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Cycle of generational failure in my life, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Cycle of generational failure in my life, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Cycle of generational failure in my life, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Cycle of generational failure in my life, break in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now say this one loud and clear. My life, you shall not be an extension of the failure of my parents in the mighty name of Jesus. My life, you shall not be an extension of the failure of my parents in the mighty name of Jesus. My life shall not be an extension of the failure of my parents in the mighty name of Jesus. My life shall not be an extension of the failure of my parents in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now say this one loud and clear. I refuse to dance to the music of satanic embarrassment in the name of Jesus. I refuse to dance to the music of satanic embarrassment in the mighty name of Jesus. I refuse to dance to the music of satanic embarrassment in the mighty name of Jesus. I refuse to dance to the music of satanic embarrassment in Jesus' mighty name we pray. I'll say this one loud and clear. Raise up your voice as you shout it. Say, poverty in my foundation, before I open my eyes, clear away in the mighty name of Jesus. Poverty in my foundation, before I open my eyes, clear away in the mighty name of Jesus. Poverty in my foundation, before I open my eyes, clear away in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now say, power eating up my confidence in God, die in the mighty name of Jesus. Power eating up my confidence in God, die in the mighty name of Jesus. Power eating up my confidence in God, die in the mighty name of Jesus. Power eating up my confidence in God, die in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now say this one loud and clear. The seed of greatness that the Almighty God has planted in my life shall manifest by fire. The seed of greatness that the Almighty God has planted in my life shall manifest by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. The seed of greatness that the Almighty God has planted in my life, it shall manifest by fire in the name of Jesus. The seed of greatness that the Almighty God has planted in my life, you shall manifest by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. The seed of greatness that the Almighty God has planted in my life shall manifest by fire in Jesus' mighty name we pray. So shall it be that the seed of greatness that the Almighty God has planted in your life shall manifest by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. And every raging battle against you today shall be quenched in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil priest ministering against you on any evil altar, they shall fall down and die in the mighty name of Jesus. And any power that has been making evil pronouncement against you on any satanic altar, they shall fall down and die in the mighty name of Jesus. The angel of your breakthrough shall be released by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. The Almighty God will cause blessings to pursue you from every direction in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. A loud amen. Another powerful amen. Amen. God bless you. Amen. This morning we are sharing together the topic that is called the faith that you need for your miracle. You see, the matter of faith is very, very important in the life of believer. And so we are going to look at the book of Hebrew. You know, the book of Hebrew, particularly chapter 11, is actually devoted to the subject of faith. From the very beginning to the very end, it's all about faith. You know, the book of Hebrews chapter 11. So we're going to be looking at two verses, verse 1 and verse 6. You know, it is devoted to the subject of faith. Starting from Abel, Enoch, Noah, Abraham and Sarah, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph, Moses, Joshua, and so many others who did exploit, who worked miracles, who brought dead people back to life, who caused rivers to be divided. You know, these men and women, they got what they got by faith. And so, we are looking at the book of Hebrew now. We'll look at verse 1 and then we'll look at verse 6. Verse 1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Then verse 6 says, but without faith it is impossible to please him. That is, without faith you cannot please God. Without faith you can't please him. That's what verse 6 says. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. I'm praying for somebody today that God will help you to believe God for your miracle today in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, he that cometh to God must believe. You know, you cannot win the attention of God. You cannot attract God's attention by tears. You cannot attract God's attention by sorrowing, by worrying. You know, none of those things moves God. The only thing that moves the hand of God to work miracle in your life is the faith you demonstrated towards him. It is faith that moves God. The Bible says anything you do outside faith, it cannot please God. You sing without faith, it cannot please God. You give without faith, it cannot please God. You pray without faith, it's not acceptable to God. You fast without faith, it's not acceptable to God. You know, faith is what you need to get your miracle. So you need faith. I pray, may the Almighty God help you today to have the kind of faith that moves the hand of God on your behalf, in your direction, in the mighty name of Jesus. Faith is the currency of heaven, with which you can, you know, procure, or with which you can have, you know, anything that you want, anything that you desire. You know, in every country, they have their currencies. You know, Nigeria spends naira, and the UK spend pounds, and the USA spend dollar. So if you want to buy anything from any of these countries, you need to go with their particular currency. The same way, in heaven, they don't spend dollar, they don't spend pound, they don't spend naira. What you need to procure anything from the supermarket of heaven is faith. But once you have faith, you'll be able to get what you want. You know, you want healing for your body, you need faith. You want victory in the battle of life, you want to triumph over all the forces that are against your life, you need faith. You need faith to move from where you are to the place where you're supposed to be. You need faith to move to the very top that you desire in life. So faith is what you need to move the hand of God on your behalf. In the first place, can I tell you something? That even as believers, there is no way you can be a believer if you don't have faith. Because the people that are called believers are people who believe that Jesus, you know, came to this world to die for our sins on the cross of Calvary. And by dying for our sin, he died and resurrected and went to heaven. And we believe him. You know, we believe that what he did on the cross was sufficient to wash away all our sins. That's why they call us believers. And the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 9 says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus. That's why anyone who became a believer, how did you become a believer? You confess Jesus. And what again? You believe. The Bible says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God raised him from the dead, say thou shalt be saved. Just by believing that Jesus went to the cross and died and then resurrected and went to heaven, and once you believe in him, the Bible says you are saved. That's how we are saved. We confess Jesus and we believe in him, and that's why we are saved. So whatever you do that is not by faith. The Bible says it cannot please God. The Bible says we walk by faith, we don't walk by sight. You know the meaning of that? We are not moved by what we see. We are not even moved by what others say. We are not moved by the events around us. Because by the time you look at the way things are going on around us, there is tendency to look at things and conclude that there is no chance for me. But to us as believers, we don't move by events that is happening around us. We don't move by what we see. We don't move by what people say. We move by the word of God. We move by what the word of God says. That's what moved us. We are not even moved by our feelings. Because if it's by our feelings, you will not be able to walk by faith. We don't move by our feeling. We don't move by the physical signs of things that we are seeing around us. We don't even move by our experiences, you know, because we have different experiences of life. But those things, we are not moved by them. If you are going to walk with God, you will set your brain, that logic, that human logic, you set it aside. You want to move by God, that aspect of human, you know, calculation of things, you will set it aside. The human reasoning, aspect of human being, you will set it aside. And then walk by faith. Follow God by faith. Believe God because His word says so. You know, the Bible said that anything that you do that is not accompanied by faith, the Bible says it's a sin. The book of Romans chapter 14 verse 23, it says, and he that doubted is damned. The word damned is the person is doomed. That is, when you don't believe, you doubted the word of God, the person is damned. The Bible says, he that doubted is damned if he eat, because he eateth not of faith. For whatsoever is not of faith is a sin. So how many of us, by doubting, by unbelief, by fear, by worry, we are committing sin, doubting the word of God? All the people that walk with God, they all walk with God by faith. They all did the miracle that you see them doing by faith. Nobody can please God without faith. You know, I remember the story of a woman. This woman had no money. She had nothing in the house. She kept trusting God. She kept believing God. Say, God, I want you to provide for me and make a way for me. And one of these days, he heard a voice. The voice said to her, go to the nearby supermarket. I mean, this woman asked the voice and said, what will I be doing in the supermarket? I don't have money. I mean, I don't have money to buy anything. Anyway, she obeyed the voice. When she got to the supermarket, the voice said to her, pick the trolley and begin to pick items that you want, that you desire. She protested again and said, I say I don't have money. How can I be picking things? What if they ask me to pay for it? I don't have money. Anyway, she obeyed the voice. She went and picked the trolley, very big trolley. And then she started picking things one after the other, started picking things. And when the trolley was filled, the voice came to her again and said, pick another trolley. She was worried, but anyway, she obeyed. She picked the second trolley and started, you know, picking items. The second trolley too was filled up. The voice came again, said, pick the third trolley. And to cut a long story short, up to 7 trolleys loaded with different items. The voice said, now you can go to the cashier where you will pay. And she went there. Just at the point that she got there, there was an announcement from the microphone of the supermarket. The supermarket, they were doing the anniversary of the supermarket actually started. And then before that time, they have already agreed that anybody that was able to, you know, hit the particular number, with whatever the person, you know, bought, it will not pay anything. That was how the woman was, you know, giving all those things, 7 trolleys loaded with items, and she didn't pay anything. That is how to walk with God. You know, acting in obedience to to the word of God. You know, as simple as the word may look, it may not even make sense to you, but acting upon it is what makes sense. It's what brings the miracle. I mean, how do you explain the story of Abraham? God came to him and said, now leave your father's house and leave your kindred and go leave your country and go to the place that I will show you. I mean, it doesn't make sense. A old man just packing his load and then the people start asking, where are you going? He said, well, I'm going, I don't know the place. I mean, people will say, what is wrong with you? You don't know where you are going. Just pack your load, carry your wife and all your properties, and you are just moving on the street. But that is what it takes to walk with God. That is what it takes to walk with God. Jehoshaphat was going to fight one of the most formidable enemies of his time. In fact, the story added that the three nations, they've all conspired together to eliminate the children of Israel. And at that time, Jehoshaphat was the king. And Jehoshaphat prayed to God. And God said, well, in this battle, what I wanted you to do is just pick your instrument of praises. Pick your tambourine, your trumpet, and your violin, and go to the battlefield and start singing and dancing. I mean, who will ever believe such a thing? Does it make sense? Your enemies are hung with all kinds of, you know, gun and the machetes and all kinds of fighting instruments, AK-47, GP, and so many other things like that. And you are just coming with tambourine, you know. It doesn't make sense. But with God, it may not make sense, but it will command blessings. It will bring your testimony. It will bring your blessings. That's how to walk with God. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 7 say, we walk by faith and not by sight. Let me hear you say, I walk by faith and not by sight. Let me hear you say it again. I walk by faith and not by sight. You know, meaning that you will not only concentrate your life based on what you see. You know, something happened in 2 Kings chapter 6 from, you know, verse 24. In chapter 6 verse 24, there was such a serious famine in Samaria. You know, the famine was so severe that there was no food. Two women came together. They both agreed that, okay, let's let the first one bring a child, and then the next time another person will bring a child. That was how the two of them agreed. So one lady volunteered her own child. They killed the child, and then they started hitting the child. To tell you how severe the famine was in Samaria, you know, it was so serious. Then it was in the midst of this famine that a man of God came up and said, by this time tomorrow, meaning that in the next 24 hours, that the situation of this country is going to change. I mean, who will believe that? There was a one man there who was an academician. I mean, he just looked at the man of God and said, Abba, what kind of prophecy is this? How would this thing that you said, how will it be possible? Even if God opens the window in heaven, do you think this thing will be? Because, I mean, it's like looking at our country today and say, well, at this time tomorrow, in the next 24 hours, you see this bag of rice that they are selling for 25,000 naira, now it's going to be sold for 500 naira. Who will believe that? Particularly the economist. They will not believe that. That was what the man said. He said, but this thing you said is not possible. And the man of God looked at him and said, well, it will surely be. You will see it, but you will not have a taste of it. Actually, the miracle happened. And when the miracle was going to happen, the king appointed the same man to man the gate so that people would not, you know, to at least to man the gate to make sure that everything is done in order. But because the prophecy must actually be fulfilled, people trampled upon him and he died. I pray that the miracle that will change your story, the testimony that we announce that we are serving a living God, will happen to you in the next 24 hours in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything that you have been expecting, the miracle that you have been expecting, before 24 hours, you shall take a delivery in the mighty name of Jesus. The good news that you desire to hear, before 24 hours, that good news shall arrive in the mighty name of Jesus. That good news shall arrive in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever power that is sitting on your blessing, they will be unseated in the next 24 hours in the mighty name of Jesus. Every meeting that needs to be heard for your life to move forward in the next 24 hours, that meeting shall be heard in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, before the expiration of 24 hours, your miracle shall be delivered. Your miracle shall be delivered. Your miracle shall be delivered. In the mighty name of Jesus, your miracle shall be delivered. In the mighty name of Jesus. You know, there is something you will read in Mark chapter number 9. Verse 23, Jesus said, he said, unto him that believeth, all things are possible. That's Mark chapter 9, verse 23. Anyone that believe, all things are possible. The meaning of that, this verse, is that, you know, we've always said that all things are possible unto God. But at the same time, the person who believed, all things are possible unto him. Just as all things are possible with God, once you can also believe too, all things are possible unto you. You can be healed if you believe. That deliverance you desire can take place if you believe. All things are possible with God for those who believe. The Bible says some people did not receive their miracle because the word of God they are hearing does not mix up with faith in their heart. Do you know the reason why people attended services and the word of God came out, the presence of God, the power of God was present? The reason is because the word of God that they heard did not mix up with faith in their heart. Anytime the word of God that you are hearing mix up with faith in your heart, miracle is bad. Anytime the word of God you are hearing mix up with faith in your heart, you will see that wonders, miracle will just happen. The result will be outstanding blessing. Anytime the word that you are hearing is mixed up with faith in your heart, the next thing that will happen is blessings. The Bible says, in Mark chapter 11, verse 24, anytime you pray, he said, wherever you pray, you must believe in your heart that you shall receive and you shall have whatsoever you believe. So anytime you are praying and you believe that you will receive what you are praying for, heaven says you will surely receive. You will surely receive. You will surely receive in the name of Jesus. You will surely receive in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, men of faith, women of faith, they don't give up about life. When you see people of faith, they are rugged. They will continue to hold on to the word of God in the face of contrary events. They will continue to hold on to God in the face of, you know, events speaking contrary to what they are holding on to. You know, like the Bible says about Abraham. The Bible says Abraham did not stagger concerning the promise of God concerning himself and his wife. He did not stagger at the promise of God. The Bible said Abraham was strong in faith. He believed God. He didn't waver. He didn't doubt. He didn't allow unbelief in his mind towards the word of God, towards what God has promised him. And to those of you who are hearing me today, there shall be a delivery of what the Lord has promised you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, for men of faith, for women of faith, they believe that, you know, weeping may endure to the night, that joy will come in the morning. You see, when you are holding on to God, and when you are holding on to the word of God, you don't give up about life. No matter the situation you are facing, no matter the challenges that are coming your way, particularly when you have prayed about it, sometimes on the enemy of our souls, particularly when you pray, you will see that the event that will be coming will look contrary, will be, you know, just to shake your faith, just to make you doubt that what you believe is coming. But in such instance, hold on to the word of God. The word of God is superior to what you are saying now. God is bigger than your problem. God is bigger than what you are going through. You know, remember that song, rather. It said, bigger than all my problem, oh, bigger than everything. God is bigger than every mountain, high stand I cannot see. Bigger than all my problem, oh, bigger than everything. God is bigger than every mountain, high stand I cannot see. God is bigger than what you are passing through now. God is bigger than the challenge that is facing you. God is bigger than all the enemies that are facing you, all the battles that are raging against you. And I pray for you that those battles, the Lord will silence them in the mighty name of Jesus. The Almighty God will silence them for you in the mighty name of Jesus. It is expected that you must demonstrate faith in the power and in the ability of God. You know, one man came to Jesus. He said to Jesus, he said, my servant is sick at home. And Jesus said, okay, I will follow you to go to your house and pray for your servant. The man said, no, sir, you don't need to follow me. Just speak your word. I believe that your word that you speak now will go to the house where my servant is lying down. The word of God that you speak will trace the address. The word of God that you are speaking will jump over high-rising building and will go and trace my servant that is sick wherever he is. That word will hit him on the bed. And the man was right. The Bible said, Jesus looked at him and said, what a strong faith. And Jesus spoke right there. And the word of God that Jesus said that day jump over a rising building and went to the particular house where the servant was sick lying down, and the word hit him there, and then the man got up. I pray that the word of God that you need to rise and shine, that word shall come to you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. You know, the disciples, one of the days, they were on the high sea, and then the storm came. You know, the wind started blowing. Meanwhile, Jesus was with them in the ship, but he was sleeping. They went to him. They said, you don't even care that we perish. I mean, look at the situation that we are facing and you are sleeping. Can you imagine? Jesus said to them, why is it that you don't have faith? How can I be with you inside this storm and you think this storm can come here and kill you? That is how we believers, that's how we behave too. You know, we believe that the situation that is confronting us is big enough to swallow us. Meanwhile, the Lord God Almighty is with us in the situation we are passing through. The word of God said the Lord is with us. So, brothers and sisters, allow your faith to mix up with the word of God. Allow your faith to mix up with the word of God. One of the days, you know, in the days of Jesus, four friends, they heard that Jesus was holding a crusade somewhere. They went to their friend. They picked their friend and they took him to the crusade. They wanted Jesus to pray for their friend. When they got there, there was no space. Everywhere was jam-packed. The road was blocked, the window, the doors. And these four friends, they thought of what to do. They broke the roof and they let down their friend that was sick in front of Jesus where he was. Jesus was so amazed that people could go to this extent. Jesus looked at them and said, this is mighty faith. This is strong faith. And right there, Jesus commanded the man that was sick, terribly sick, to rise up. And the man rose up. You see, when you demonstrate faith in the power of God, certainly you will see wonders. You will see miracle. You will see wonder. How did the woman with the issue of blood, how did she got a miracle? She believed before she left her house. Said, look, I am going there now. I'm going to be healed. I'm going to come out. He said, I don't need him to pray for me. I just need to touch the hem of his garment. And heaven heard her. And when she got there, she touched the hem of the garment. She was made whole. I pray that whatever miracle that you are expecting today, receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Of course, let me let you know that there are enemies of faith. Enemies of faith. Number one is fear. Anytime fear comes, faith is paralyzed. You know, anytime you walk by faith, you attract God. Anytime you allow fear in your life, you attract the devil. Faith and fear, they cannot work together. They cannot mix together. Once fear enters, faith jump out. And once faith enters, fear will pick race. I pray the Lord will strengthen you today in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray the Lord will strengthen you today in the mighty name of Jesus. The next one, the second enemy of faith is unbelief. And this, you don't believe. You don't believe the word of God. The Bible says, he that doubted is already doomed. Anyone that doubt, the Bible says, whatsoever you ask God, we must ask in faith without doubting. Because the Bible says that he that doubted is like a wave of the sea, driven with wind and tossed. The Bible says, let that man, let him not think that he can receive anything from God. So when you doubt, you don't receive anything from God. That's James chapter 1, 6 to 8. So number 3 is negative confession. Your word must align with the word of God. Your word must agree with the word of God. If God says you are blessed, believe it. If God says you are healed, it doesn't matter what you are feeling. Take the word of God and disregard your feeling. Disregard what you are feeling. God said, believe and you will receive miracle. That's exactly what it is. Whatever God says. So don't allow your word to be contrary to what God says. If God says you are the head, begin to confess that you are the head. And as a believer, can I say this to you? We need to learn the power of speaking words. What do I mean by that? That is, learn to confess the word of God. Whatever God says about you, you know, as you read your Bible, for instance, Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, you know what it says? I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. That scripture, you should confess it over and over and over. You will see that you will have strength. You know, Philippians chapter 4, verse number 19 says, God has supplied all my needs according to his riches in glory. That scripture is very powerful. You must continue to confess it and believe it. As you confess it, you believe it. Romans chapter 8, verse 37 says, I am more than conqueror through him that loved me, through God that strengthened me. You know, 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14 says, now thanks be unto God, which always caused me to triumph in Christ Jesus. I see you triumphing in the name of Jesus. You will surely triumph over all your enemies in the name of Jesus. So that is number 3 enemies. Number 4 enemies is negative, you know, dwelling on the negative experiences of the past. You know, as children of God, there are certain experiences we had in the past. You must look away from them. You must not allow your feeling to control you. Allow the word of God to control you. Number 5 is impatient. So for everyone that must receive the miracle from God, you must be patient with God. The reason Abraham is called the father of faith today is because he was patient with God. He was not moved by what he saw. He was not moved by his condition. The Bible said he was strong in faith. He believed God and it was accounted for him for righteousness. I see you taking delivery of your breakthrough today in the mighty name of Jesus. I see you taking delivery of your breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, after you have done the will of God, you still need to be patient with God. You still need to be patient with God. And I want to pray for you. And the Almighty God will surprise you today in the mighty name of Jesus. The Almighty God will surprise you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You know, poor knowledge of the word of God is also another enemies of faith. You know, many Christians, they don't read the word of God. How will you have faith? You know, it is when you read the word of God and you see the promise of God for you there. You know, for instance, the word of God says you want financial prosperity, then you must give. But many believers, they don't believe the word of God. They don't, you know, you will see many believers who are praying for miracle, who are praying for financial breakthrough, very stingy to God. They don't pay their tithe, they don't pay their offering. How will God bless you? You don't sow seed, you don't give to your prophet. How would God bless you? You know, God said, give and it shall be given. That's the condition for prosperity. And of course, the last one is lack of love. When you know, all that you concentrate in the house of God is, you know, your miracle. You just want your miracle. You don't love God. You are just looking into the hand of God. You don't have the love of God in your heart. You will not be able to receive your miracle. God says, love me. Don't love the material things that he can give. Many people come to the house of God. They are not contributing. They are not doing anything for God. All that they are interested in, oh God, solve my problem, solve problem. God said, no. First of all, love me first. Serve me. Obey me. And you will see the wonders of God in your life. And not only that, I say you should love your fellow men. Today, I see God giving you the miracle you desire in the name of Jesus. And I want to let you know that when you want your faith to grow, you must always listen to the word of God. You must always listen to testimony. Testimony has the capacity to reproduce itself in your life. When you hear that God has healed somebody, that testimony that you heard means that the same thing that happens to the person can be repeated, can happen to you. That's how our faith grows in the things of God. I see God blessing you today. Your life will never be the same again in the mighty name of Jesus. God is going to surprise you this week in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to raise up your two hands to the heavenly and pray this prayer with the most aggressive that you can gather. I want you to shout it at the top of your voice. Say, where is the Lord God of signs and wonder? Arise and manifest yourself in my life today in the mighty name of Jesus. Where is the Lord God of signs and wonder? Arise and manifest your power in my life today in the mighty name of Jesus. Where is Lord God of signs and wonder? Arise and manifest your power in my life today in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now say, any power boasting against my moving forward, die in the mighty name of Jesus. Any power boasting against my moving forward, fall down and die in the mighty name of Jesus. Any power boasting against my moving forward, fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. I pray for every person. The Almighty God shall visit you today. That healing that you want, receive it in the name of Jesus. That deliverance that you desire, take it now in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that the word of God shall bring healing to your body today in the mighty name of Jesus. I withdraw your blessings from the evil altar in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. The name of God the Father, the name of God the Son, the name of God the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood,
in the soul?